Hi everyone, my name is Rosie Wickland and today I'm going to teach you how to sew a top or a dress bodice that's lined. There's so many reasons to do a lined bodice, because it will carry the weight of a heavy skirt better, because you like a thicker top, maybe because it covers something that you want covered, like a binder or a minimizing bra, or your chest attributes, whatever the reason. I love, love, love lining shirts. And they're really awesome because for many new sewists getting used to working with knit, doing a binding or a band is one of the most intimidating parts of the process. And many times these patterns with facings, you know, like a little bit of a lining but not fully lined, just don't stay in. They flop out like a shirt tag that just won't cooperate. So this is a really great way that we can build either a shirt or a bodice for a dress. And I am so excited to be sharing this with you. Thanks for watching.
Bip 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 b
you've watched me cut a lot of things now. Let's talk about what we did, okay? So, I've made a lining for my cross bust top. It's a mirror image. So there's one that goes this way, and one that goes this way. And here's my back. And I've made a back in my main fabric to my cross bust top. And a front in my main fabric. And you'll see that it's mirrored. And then I cut the sleeves. And these are cut on the fold sleeves, which is definitely my preference. I just get a better fit with these. And there's two sleeves. And then you'll see where I was doing a lot of folding and guesstimation. So here's what I did. I took my back piece, and the front, when it's all lined up, will be about the same width. And I laid my fabric down, and I made it twice as wide as the back piece so that there's a front and a back. So, see how this just matches up? Front piece, back piece. So it's just double the width of the back piece. And I made it about, let's say, 6 or 7 inches tall, because when I fold it over, I'll have about a 3-inch waistband on the bottom of my top, which I like. So those are all the pieces for my cross bust. And now I'm making a sleeveless tank top here. And it's just a regular scoop neck. So here's the lining on the, and that's for the back. Here's the lining for the front. And I added a little clip to my front piece in my main fabric and my lining fabric because they can be hard to tell apart. And here's my main fabric for the back. And here's my main fabric for the front. Cute, right? Okay. So now we're gonna put them together. Okay, and here's one more thing I've done. I've taken my little cute character fabric and I fold it in half. And it's about double my width, just a guesstimate. And it's about the length I like for a skirt. I just eyeballed it. And what I'm going to end up doing is a side seam and a hem and a quick gather. So I have a very simple dress, which I'm going to attach to the bodice of my tank top. And then the cross bust top, I am just going to put a waistband on, so it's a top. But all these different pieces and styles and ideas you can mix and match. And you could even use my circle skirt tutorial and put a circle or a half circle skirt. Just attach it to the bodice and don't even worry about making a waistband. Not fun. Okay, maybe one more thing. I'm gonna take this scrap of fabric and I'm gonna fold it in half widthwise, and then I'm gonna fold it in half lengthwise. And I'm gonna trim off this excess. Go. So the long tail I put on is trimmed off, and now I've got in half lengthwise and half widthwise. I'm going to come over here. I'm just going to eyeball a pocket. Apart from each other. So I have 4 pieces that are mirrored. So that I could stitch this right into the side seam of my skirt and have a little pocket. We'll talk about how to do that here in just a second. serger, curve the seams of my pocket a little bit more, and it's all well attached, and the side seams of my skirt are all sewn up, so I'm just going to turn it out and let you have a little look. And this is really fun because once we do the bodice, I'm going to show you how I gather the top, but I'm just going to poke in these end seam pockets. And I'm not going to put a novel in there. I'm not going to put, you know, stabby things on my keys in there. If I want to put my keys in there, I need to not keep stabby things on my keys because I'm going to rip my skirt. But I can put a candy bar in there, and I can put my phone in there, assuming I don't have a really big phone. And I don't. Mine's pretty average size. If you have a really big phone, maybe trace it when you're doing your pockets so that your pockets are big enough. And also consider the weight, because we love knit because it's stretchy. But if we put something really heavy in here, it's gonna stretch it. So don't forget about that, okay? But yeah, I'm just gonna throw a hem on this. And when we finish our bodice, we'll talk about how we're gonna gather this and then attach it. And this, we could also gather this and just attach it to the waistband that we did from our circle skirt. Easy peasy, right? Cool. So I love it when we start hacking or just exploring all the different ways you can put all the patterns you already have, all the clothing you already have that you can trace together in a way that you love. That's my favorite. Okay. All right, next step of this process. We are going to take the lining for our tank top dress, the front piece and the back piece. We're going to clip it at the shoulder side, okay? Clippity clip. And because it's fun to do this streamline, we're going to grab the front piece and the back piece of our main fabric, and we're gonna, anybody? Clip it at the shoulder seams. Now, if at this point you realized that your shoulder seams are not matching up very great, just trim them a little bit. Mine ended up pretty okay this time, but like, don't panic. It's okay. And you'll see that I'm clipping both my main fabric and my lining fabric with the pretty sides inside. I'm not looking at anything fancy right now. Now, I am going to serge all these shoulder seams. Thank you. So this neckline is really well serged, and we want to make sure that we just look at it. Just look at it and go around it and take a moment to make sure that you really caught all the fabric and it's really well stitched in. But once we've done that, we're gonna flip it inside itself, and this is gonna feel strange. But what we're doing is we're setting it so that the lining is inside and the main fabric is outside. Isn't that cool? Now we're gonna do something you might find terrifying, but it's very thrilling. Now at this point, if you wanted to, you could clip your sides down and you could make a little armband and call it good. And that would be perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with that. Or you could tuck in your side seams and just add a stitch and then stitch your sides down, and that would be great. But what I'm gonna show you how to do is called the burrito method. And it's not only called the burrito method because you roll stuff inside, it's called the burrito method because it gives a delicious result. All your seams are gonna be inside. There's gonna be no seams to mess with you. You're gonna be seamless or secret seamed. Okay, so watch what I'm gonna do. And it is strange, I know. I'm gonna take one side of my fabric. It really won't matter if my mane or my lining is facing up or down right now, as long as it's all pretty side out. See, pretty side, pretty side. Oh. And I'm gonna spread this out on my table, and I'm gonna start rolling one end toward the other. Feels weird, because it is weird. Roll, 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 roll. Just keeping it smooth as I roll, because the tighter it is, the smoother it is, the easier it's gonna be. Now you see right here, I have gotten to my other sleeve, right? What I'm gonna do is lift up, in this case, it's the lining, and I'm just gonna flop that over. Now, see, my overall is underneath this sleeve, right? I'm gonna trap it in there. And so now my lining is inside this sleeve. See how I rolled it all up and it's inside there, and I'm gonna start clipping it. I'd like to show you the burrito from another angle, just like we've done before. I wanna make sure you really get this if you wanna get it. So I'm gonna try to give it to you. So it's laying flat, neck seam is inside, we flipped it out, getting a little fuzz off. Now I'm gonna grab just one side. It all lines up, but I'm not gonna fuss with smoothing it out perfectly. And see, I'm just rolling it. Just roll, roll, roll. And when it's rolled and it's come upon the other sleeve, I'm gonna grab that and pull it over. Pull it over, pull it over. And that little roll I made is now inside the other sleeve. I'm just gonna clip it, taking care not to. Oh no, this is fun. I'm clipping with my non-dominant hand. Taking care not to catch that little roll I made inside my clip. I want it nice and stuffed inside. All right, humans, I've clipped with my non-dominant hand. I look forward to my heroes parade. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and just clip all along what is going to be the sleeve line. And I'm gonna switch my camera angle, so I'm not trying to do this with my non-dominant hand, because my hand is like, no thank you, please stop. So, just one more time. We're gonna do this at an angle. And it's not gonna be the most flattering angle to my face, but it may be helpful. Again, pretty sides are facing out. I'm just gonna grab any one side of my bodice, not the top and the bottom, which will make the
end of my bodice, right? Whoa. Not this, this. I'm gonna grab this. I'm gonna roll it down. Roll it, roll it, roll it. Just like you're packing for camping, we're rolling our clothes. Roll, 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 roll. And when we get to what makes up the other sleeve, I'm gonna flip it so that it ends up with the roll inside. And it is okay if it takes you a while or forever to get your hands to do that. It took me a really, really, really long time. Really long time. For a long time, I just put sleeves on this, which is fine because I didn't like doing bands. That's okay. So now, see where the seam is, I put a clip. And now, I'm just gonna clip all the way along the curve that makes up the sleeve. And you'll see where the curve stops because it's gonna go curve, 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 and then to the bodice. So we're just gonna clip all that. And I also have a blog post on how to do the burrito method that is step by step with photos, and I'm gonna post that in the description here so that you can also reference that if you find that text and photos are easier for you than video. If this is really easy for you, I just think you're awesome, but it's okay if it's not easy for you. It's okay if you have to work at this a bit, and it's okay if it's hard. Just stop and have tea and have water. And get a hug if you want a hug. Okay, so, see where my clips are. I am going to now serge along the clips. And I'm gonna, before I start serging, and even stopping as I'm stopping completely, taking my foot off the pedal, turning off the machine, just shoving this roll inside there so that it's nowhere near where I'm stitching, okay? So that I'm not stitching into that roll, I'm just stitching the side seam that's gonna make up the sleeves, okay? Okay. Snakes had live birth, it would be exactly like this. And I'm gonna gently pull. And having done this 100 million times, I am still always amazed. Look it, look it, look it, look it. So it's done. And I am just going to speed up the video and repeat the process on the other side, okay? Okay. Thank you. could put our, take our main fabric and make sure it's on the inside, and then clip these sides together and serge it shut, and that would be great, right? Because we'd be like done if we did that on both sides, and all we'd have to do is connect a waistband or hem the bottom or put a gathered skirt or a circle skirt or a half circle skirt or a high-low skirt or a handkerchief skirt. Oh my gosh, the options are like endless. But here's what we're gonna do, and this is cool. See what I did here? I'm gonna take the side. See how we got these little side seams at the end of where we did our burrito? I'm gonna match them up. So that the main, all along the side here, the lining is getting sewn to the lining, right? On the side seam. And the main is getting clipped to the main fabric, all along the side of the bodice. We can come over to our other side and we can do the same thing. Line it up at the seam. Clip there. And then main fabric is going to go to the main fabric all along the side. Okay, and so when the side seams are clipped together, you just have this weird looking thing, right? But what we're gonna do is we're gonna serge down these sides, okay? Okay. Myself. So if I want to, I can top stitch around my neckline and my sleeves, but I don't want to because I'm super sensitive and like not feeling stitching is like bliss for me. So see, here's my main, right? It looks great, I think. But when I turn it inside out, there's no point where I feel any stitching because it's all hidden inside. Now, at this point, I could fold the edges of the main and the lining fabric inside. See, just kind of like fold them in like a quarter inch and clip them together and just stitch around the whole bottom and call it a day. And then I would have a completely reversible top, which is really fun. And I could even do that with like a plain colored or double side printed skirt like sandwiched in there so that it was like a totally reversible dress. That's wild, right? Or I could put a band on this and it wouldn't be reversible because you'd see the stitch on the band, but it'd be very comfy and cute. Or I could attach a skirt to it like I'm about to do. So when I'm attaching a skirt to something, I actually like to make sure that I'm lining up the side seams of my bodice and just clip everything together and serge the bottom so that I'm not like worried that my lining is gonna get rumpled from my bodice when I attach the skirt. I can just sort of chill on that point. Like, it's gonna be okay. I'm not sewing three loose pieces together that are all jiggling about. I just got the two. So the beauty of this is that you could take your favorite t-shirt and you could trace the front and you could trace the back and you could line it and add any kind of skirt you want and make like infinity of your favorite t-shirt and make it into a million different kinds of dresses and play with different kinds of skirts you can have and pair them with comfy pants and shorts. And you've got like a whole wardrobe with like five patterns, which may not even have been patterns, but clothes you loved and traced. It's just kind of amazing when you think about it. Okay, at this point I'm going to show you how I gather on my Brother 1030 4D. This is one of my favorite sergers on the market because they are so accessible, they're affordable, you can find them a lot of places, and they're a real workhorse. They hold up really well. So here's what I'm going to do a simple gather. I'm going to start out by setting my left and right needle to 5. Normally my settings are 4-4-4. And I can even try cranking it up to 6 to try and get that tighter gather, but sometimes it's gonna end up kind of wiggling and breaking the thread when I do that, or even the needle. So just pick your battles. And now I'm gonna come over to the side of the machine right here and change my stitch length all the way up to the top where it's going to show a ruffle. And now I'm just going to feed the top of my skirt through. Remember, we don't want our pockets on the very, very bottom. So we're just going to feed this through and go ahead and see if that doesn't end up pretty close to the size of the opening at the bottom of our bodice. It should, because it's about double. And this is going to about double reduce the fabric. It's going to make it about half as wide at the opening. It's not a perfect science, but it usually works well. Let's try. I end up having to stretch the bottom of the bodice just a little bit to match it, but I feel like that's fine. I'm just going to stretch it while I clip. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn it so that my bodice is inside out. I'm looking at my lining only now. And I am going to take this, I'm going to slide it over the top opening of my skirt. And I'm going to clip the side seam of the skirt to the side seam of the bodice. And remember, I'm looking at the wrong side so that when I pull it up, the stitch is going to be on the inside and all the correct sides of the fabric are matched up. Now, again, I'm just looking for the side seam of the fabric. I'm looking for the side seam of the bodice and lining those up. Now remember, my skirt was just the teeniest bit bigger than my bodice. If I felt like it was quite a lot bigger, I would go ahead and trim off that teeny tiny bit of the gathering stitch so that I'm coming at it with a fresh stitch, you know, just razor that edge off because it's a little teeny bit. And then I'm gonna try and crank my needles up a little bit higher, my left and right needle, so that it's giving me an even tighter gather. But if I'm only trying to double my fabric, it should be able to do that for me, and it did. Okay, so now I've got a clip in the front, a clip in the back, and a clip on the sides. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna gently stretch my bodice, right? And throw a clip in the middle. I'm not stretching the skirt as I do that, I'm just laying the skirt, because the skirt is already plenty big. Now I have done this quite a few times, but you may want to, after you're done clipping the whole way around, do a basting stitch on your sewing machine. Again, I'm just gently stretching the bodice, and I'm gonna throw a clip in the middle, so that this is pretty evenly gathered onto my bodice. You may wanna throw like a loose, straight stitch on to your bodice where you attach it to your skirt, and just make sure that you're happy with it. And if you're not happy, you can unpick it and maybe gather it a little tighter or gather it a little looser and just see what's feeling good for you. Me, I know that I like the look of this. So when I'm done clipping, I'm just gonna serge and I'm gonna go around twice because the point where the dress bodice connects to a skirt that has pockets is gonna be a bit of a stress point. There's gonna be a good amount of weight and tension as you're pulling on that. So I'm just gonna serge twice for another clip. All right. Last time here, I'm gonna gently stretch the bodice. Find the middle of that to the middle of the skirt here. And then clip on. Through another one. Alright, I'm going to serge on now. Remember, my bodice is on, and I'm looking at the wrong side, the lining of the fabric, okay? My main fabric is inside, and it's all flapping down. So that when I pull it up, oh, Lord, that is so cute. So that when I pull it up, it's all having the stitch on the inside and having the lining fabric on the inside, just how I want it, okay? Oh, cute. All right, let's stitch. Thank you. with the lining is attached to our gathered skirt with pockets, and I'm gonna put a hem on. I know y'all know how to do that. And at a future time, I'm gonna do a refreshing the basics where we talk about all the different parts of the sewing machine, all the different parts of the serger, and some great basic tips like hemming. But for today, I'm just going to slap a hem on this, and let's move on to lining a crossbust top, okay? Okay. I will model that at the end, so don't worry. You'll get a chance to see how it looks in action. So, first things first, I'm gonna take the back of what's gonna be my crossbust top. And I am going to grab, make sure that I'm appropriately crossing, and putting my right side together, and then connect the shoulder seam. We don't want to accidentally put that on backwards or something. Make it so that it was going over here some which way. Okay. Like, if I were to put it this way, it would be going all off in the wrong direction, but still right sides facing. So we're going to come over here and make it right sides facing. And connect the shoulder seam. All right. Now, I'm going to grab my lining and I'm going to repeat the process. Right sides facing, connect the shoulder seam. Right sides facing, going in the correct direction. Connect the shoulder seam. And just like before, we're gonna sew those shoulder seams, okay? And then we'll see how we connect our bodice to our lining. it so that our lining is on the inside and our main fabric is on the outside and the pretty side is facing out. Now if we wanted to at this point, we could burrito the sleeves just like we've done before, but I want to add a sleeve to this. And using this pattern, we can mix and match. So we can put a sleeve on our tank top, or we can make our crossbust sleeveless using the burrito method. But what I'm gonna do right now is show you how I insert a sleeve. So I'm gonna take what is the arm side and lay it on a table. I'm gonna take the sleeve that I cut and lay it so that it's facing pretty side down to my fabric. And see these curves? I'm gonna connect them to both sides of the arm side and connect the middle. Grab what's going to be the middle, and this is a cut on the fold sleeve. See how it's the same both ways? If you are using a sleeve that is not cut on the fold, then you're going to want to add some little notch to your pieces so that you know where and how to connect them. But see how I've clipped it in the middle, and now I'm just clipping it to the end of what's going to be the arm side. And I am flipping it to the end of what's going to be the arm side. And I'm doing it with the right sides facing, putting the pattern piece down on the main fabric when I do that. Now I'm going to add a few more clips here because I don't want to be having things wobble around while I'm trying to search. And this ends up being one of my favorite reasons I sew. Outside of my violin hips and very generous belly that makes everything roll down and roll up, and I get to grade for those things and make sure that my clothes still fit well, I also like to grade for my awesome arms. I have been working hard in the yard, and whenever I do that with any regularity, my shoulders and my upper arms and my lower arms just pack on muscle. And that can make a lot of, like, designers just seem to look at pattern blocks that just assume that anyone who is shopping in a fan section doesn't have anything going on up here. And then when I hop over to a jet section, there's not enough room up here, and then everything sits funny. So sewing my own clothes has been amazing because I have stuff here and stuff here. Go figure. So, sleeves all clipped on. And I am just going to repeat the process on the other side and serge on. Okay, so now our sleeves are attached, but our sides are not. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna fold the sleeve in half, right? We're gonna clip along the raw edge that would make up the side, the inside of the sleeve. Awesome. Now we're gonna come to the side of our bodice and we're just gonna sew it together. No, just kidding. Remember how we're doing a cross bust? We have to grab one side of our cross bust and tuck it in. So just line it up with the bottom and make sure it's sandwiched in between, right? So on one side, and I have no preference on this, but maybe you do, the cross will be tucked in. And so I'm just gonna line it up with the bottom here. On one side, the cross will go in between the bodice and the main fabric. See how it goes? Front bodice, back bodice, and that little piece of the cross bust going in between there, like a tasty sandwich filling. We're just gonna clip, making sure that all of our tasty sandwich filling, that piece of the cross bust, is kind of poking out there. It'll come into our seam allowance a bit, because we don't want it just sort of hanging and flapping. We want it really well stitched in on this side, okay? And I forgot to mention, but when our bodice was still inside out and we had just put the seam around the neck piece, we hadn't turned it right side out, that would be a point where, just like on the other bodice, we could sew some clear elastic along that seam line. And that would be our chance to make sure that that neck snaps back, even if we're frequently pulling it down for whatever reason, for chest port access, for feeding a child, or anything we want to do. So now we're going to come to the other side, and just like before, we are going to bring the sleeves together. Right? We're just going to fold them in half and bring them together. Good. All right, so now we're going to come to what's going to be the bodice sides again. And this time we can just clip down these bodice sides, and what's going to be the cross bust isn't going to be sandwiched in between. It's going to go here. And that'll just happen sort of naturally. Things are going to have to get very tangled for both of your cross busts to end up sandwiched. And just like before, we want to make sure that we're pulling this side of the cross bust through a bit past where we're serging and really coming into that seam allowance we've given ourselves, so that we can make sure that we're getting all the cross bust in there, that none of it's going to be awkwardly flapping around. We don't want that. Okay, so now I'm just going to serge down the sides of my sleeves, okay? The sides of my sleeves and my bodice. And then when I finish later, I'm going to hem these
but I'm gonna do that off camera because I'm working from the assumption that you'll know how to do simple hems and you've watched my comfy shorts video. You can do a faux cuff on the sleeve if you want to, or an actual cuff. And then I'm just gonna put the band on that I will show you. Okay, we've sewn the side seams of our bodice. Now I'm just going to reach into the sleeves on both sides and turn it out and see how it looks. Oh my goodness, I'm excited. So what I'm going to show you how to do now is to attach this waistband we've made. So what we're going to do is so much like the comfy shorts and the comfy pants and all these different things we've made. We are going to fold in half, put a stitch down the side, then we're gonna fold down and attach that. And I'm gonna do that just now. And I'll be able to actually get in this top, and the front is on the front, so we're doing good there. Now we're going to take our waistbands. I'm going to line up. There we go. Print was facing the wrong direction. I'm going to line up about the center of the seam where I stitched it together with the center of the back. You can also line it up to your side seams. You can put it off center in the front. I don't care. It's your shirt. Have fun. I mean, really, nobody's really going to be looking at that stuff. That's for you. But I'm going to clip it on.
and serge it on. And then after we hem the sleeves and hem our skirt, we're done. And you could do this a lot of ways. You could, my dog sees this girl. You could set it up so that you're doing one micro task each day, or you could set it up so that you are doing multiple pieces of clothing at the same time and just working in like a big assembly line fashion. It's up to you. Maybe you get weekends by yourself to sew sometimes, or maybe you just carve out 15 minutes here and there. Whatever it is that's working for you, just do that and give yourself permission to enjoy things. I have so much work to do on my home, and my dogs could always use more attention. I have four. I have other hobbies that I like to attend to, and I want to spend, you know, those rich quality moments one-on-one and as a group with my kids, and time I want to spend with friends and time I want to spend with my spouse. And so it's really easy to feel like, oh, one more thing, well, I'll just dump this. But for me, this is part of why I want to people right now, why I want to exist right now, is this feeling that I get this time for me to do what I want to do, to make what I want to make, to affirm the shape of my body and my gender and my preference and my interests with these pieces of clothing in this way. It's good medicine, and you deserve a little time for you. It's not work, it's not industry, it's not for other people, just time for you to make. So I'm gonna sew this waistband on.
Turned out, and I hope you love yours too. Now I want to show you my top. Okay, I put on my favorite circle skirt and probably one of my new favorite tops. I absolutely love the lined cross bust, and for the sleeve I ended up cutting it at a cap sleeve length, and I just serged the edge, folded it in, and did a zigzag stitch on my machine. And it's just really cute and really comfortable, and this one has awesome access if you are chest feeding or you're having a medical port or any other reason you might need to access your chest throughout the day. I just want to say thank you for watching my video, for taking a minute for you, and for supporting my channel. I absolutely love what I get to do here, and I feel so grateful and just blown away, because it wouldn't be possible without you. So thank you. Everything I get to do is because of your support. So I hope that your day is awesome too. I'm feeling just with the serotonin. Great. Bye.